Yeah, well, thanks for that. Actually, my career has been going on for several decades now. But apart from a start in pure mathematics, because I set out in algebra, I very quickly switched to statistics, in particular applied statistics, with a focus on medical statistics for my PhD. And ever since, I've been working in that area. It's actually throughout been work on longitudinal data, repeated measures on the one hand, incomplete data, missing data, both for categorical data as well as for continuous data. And then in particular also with some focus on clinical trials, like missing data in clinical trials, how to analyze clinical trials. And some emphasis has always been placed on surrogate marker evaluation, so surrogate endpoints instead of the true endpoint in a clinical trial. And actually, most of those indeed have led to some research output every now and then, also with a book, and that includes also books in the SAS series, of course. Yeah, I think one of the earlier ones, not the absolute earliest, but is the 2000 book published by Springer, and which I wrote together with Dietrich Beke on longitudinal data of a continuous, so Gaussian nature. So that is now almost 2 decades ago. It was followed by a book on the categorical version that was published 5 years later in 2005. And in both of those, we have actually extensively illustrated the methodology that we proposed with SAS code, with SAS programs, with SAS data analysis, etc. So it's a good question, but of course also a little bit difficult to answer because I definitely do not consider myself an expert or top SAS programmer, which may also be true for other packages I'm working with. As an academic, we work in on many different projects. We teach, we develop methodology, we look at the mathematics, we do consulting, and yes, occasionally, or frequently, I should say, there is also programming involved. But with that in mind, I have seen a few important things for myself, but also for the students I'm teaching with, for the collaborators. And that is, first and foremost, know what you're doing. That means if you do SAS programming, it's usually about relatively sophisticated data analysis tools, models, for example. Let's call it models. So if you program a model, don't go by something looks similar, I'll start modifying that code. Well, occasionally that may be useful, but really know what you're doing so that you see the map between the modeling tool, the equation, so to speak, and what you're doing in SAS. So make sure that the right thing comes out at the end of the day by really having a good working knowledge about the strategy you're working with. Familiarize yourself with what you're going to program before you program. I think that's the first thing I would definitely say. The second advice I would like to give for somebody programming, especially if you're dealing with more complicated models, and I would almost say, especially if they are non-linear models, etc., is be patient. Programming and making a program to work, of course, it needs to be syntactically correct, but let's assume that's the case. But many statistical procedures are not so straightforward in the sense you may fit a model to a set of data and it may not work simply because the starting values are not optimal or not well chosen, etc. Well, if you approach that with a mindset, tell me what the perfect starting values are, it's going to be disappointing because there is, in many cases, no absolute clear scientific reason why you should use one or the other. So don't procrastinate over it. Just be patient and try several values and build, let's say, a heuristic library by talking to others, by working yourself on it and building experience as you go. And you will see before you know it starts working. And I think as a third piece of advice, keep very familiar with developments in surrounding areas. And by that I mean, Yes, we talked about statistics and how models are translated into programming, but what I was just saying is programming is also, and getting models to converge is also numerical analysis. So a good SAS programmer should have a very good working knowledge, both on the statistical area in which you are working, as well as in the numerical analysis needed to make it work. And also there, a lot of things are happening. There is a lot of trends, especially in these big data and data science area time. So keep abreast of the evolutions there by following the literature, by attending conferences, etc., and by talking to other people. So as an aside, I think conferences especially, but not only, the SAS conferences, for example, the SAS Global Forum, etc., are extremely relevant in that setting. Yeah, well, that's perhaps an even more difficult question than the previous one, because there are several procedures that are really close to my research area, and I would almost say close to my heart. There is, of course, the various longitudinal procedures, like PROC mixed, PROC glim mixed, PROC NL mixed, etc., PROC GenMod, we can go on for a while, PROC GEE. And then there are the missing data procedures, in particular PROC MI and PROC MI Analyze. Now, that's not an answer to your question because I gave too many procedures, but I would say let me single out PROC mixed in SAS, because it's actually the one that we were using when our, not our 2000 book even, but the book in 1997 in the lecture notes in statistics series of Springer was published. That book came into being because we taught a short course in our own university on longitudinal data using the then very brand new procedure mixed. So it was foundational in that sense, and all the rest followed. So if you want a singular rather than a plural answer, I would say the mixed procedure. Yeah, like for example, in the more recent book that came out, added up by Alex Dmitrienko and Gary Cook, in which I was happy together with my candidate to contribute a chapter on missing data in clinical trials. There, of course, center stage were the mixed procedures and the GLIMIX, etc., the longitudinal procedures that I mentioned. But in particular, I think nowadays we can do so many more things when it comes to analyzing incomplete data, longitudinal or otherwise, thanks to the development of a few tools, but in particular the new procedure GEE, which allows for weighted estimating equations along with standard estimating equations. I think that was a great achievement. And then also PROC MI for multiple imputation. The procedure has been around for quite a while, but it's grown incredibly flexible because the various ways of doing multiple imputation are almost entirely, not all, there is still work to be done, but almost all implemented, including the full conditional specification method. But as the final point on that procedure, I would like to mention the tools that are now available to do sensitivity analysis around missing data using the MNAR statement in that procedure. So without going too technical, this has really made sensitivity analysis, which until recently was recommended, but you had to rely on user-defined software, etc. It has become almost routine, or it's becoming more routine than it used to be, way of analyzing data just because of the availability of that procedure. So the ones that I added are GEE and MI. Not really, but maybe one thing, I've always valued the way that SAS as a company and the developers, etc., have always maintained links, communication links, expert advice links, or whatever you call them, with the users community. So it's very important, of course. I think it's mutual benefit. It's symbiosis, really, for us as users, but also as authors of books. It's very important that the procedures that we use and that we include also as illustrations in our articles, but especially our books, are state of the art. I think for the company, it's useful to also know what where the research community is heading. And of course, it's heading in many different directions at the same time. But that dialogue, which happens formally and especially also informally, is of the utmost importance. I think that's really a strength and an asset of the way SAS is developing and the community is here.
Yes, thank you so much for sharing that with us, Professor Molenbergs. And it was echt leuk met u te kunnen spreken.
Dat is fijn.